not judge a book by its cover. Don't judge a book by its cover. Oftentimes, people may look at me in a certain light. Some people might be intimidated by me and my demeanor. Some people may have a judgment about me before they even hear me speak. It's happened plenty of times. I've been in situations to where I've sat down with people we've become to be friends through whatever means, and they was like, yo, before I met you, if I didn't know you, if I saw you walking across down the street, I would cross the street and walk the other way. And that's like bizarre to me, because I am a guy who would protect you from somebody doing some bullshit out the street anyway. Like, I'm that guy. One time, I was in Long Beach. A friend of mine was in town. We were all hanging out. It was at night. We're walking down the street, down Pine. There was these two drunk guys. One was way more drunk than the other. There was a woman on the street. They were harassing. One was harassing her. The other one, it was like he didn't want to say nothing to his buddy. So I'm walking down the street, and I know me. I'm not going to walk past and let them harass this woman and make her uncomfortable. Fortunately, by the time I got pretty close, it died out and they went away. But I would have handled that situation. Like, I'm not that guy, you know? I refer to myself, I came up with this term a long time ago, but I refer to myself as a dirty angel. I have angel wings tatted across my chest, the word angel across my stomach, an angel on my back. I've always felt like I've had guardian angels. There's numerous times in my life to where it was like death was upon me, or tragedy was upon me. And for some reason, I was scooped up and delivered out of those situations. So I always felt like I had a guardian angel. When I was a kid, I do recall one time I saw an angel. My mother had moved to Florida. I was still in New York with my grandparents. About a year later, she came and got me because she was going through some hard times. Came and got me, so it was just me and my mom. She was working a lot. So I would be home by myself often. And I'm a type of person that worries a lot because I think so much. I think of every bad thing that can happen. You know what I mean? I used to, at least. And as a kid, it was just my life was like a movie, no bullshit. When y'all see the documentary, y'all gonna know what I'm talking about. But anyway, I used to think a lot. My mind was always going. And one time she's out at work, it was nighttime. I'm in bed. I think it was a storm. Anybody know about Florida? There's some horrendous storms, like thunder. It sounded like Armageddon. And I was scared, I was nervous. The lights would flicker in and out. I'm in bed. I remember laying down, looking at my door, and I seen a wing, an angel's wing. Say the door was right here, the wing was higher than the door. I just seen all the way down, just the wing, as if somebody was on post at my bedroom door. And I felt a sense of comfort. I'm not making this shit up. I'm not one of those people that believe in ghosts and all of that shit. I don't know what's out there, but I saw that with my own eyes. But anyway, a lot of people may or may not know that I've been through a lot of shit in my life. You know what I mean? Good and bad. And all of the shit that I've been through, it made me the person that I am today. There's a reason that majority of my videos, I'm always trying to give you guys information. I'm always trying to give you guys insight and some wisdom. It's because I've seen so much. And when I see other people potentially about to go down a wrong path or do something that they shouldn't do, or stressed out about certain things, I want to speak on it. I have an inclination to speak on it, because chances are I've been in that exact situation that they've been in, you know? And to me, I believe in to whom much is given, much is expected. So I've been given a lot of wisdom. I feel like I am rich with wisdom, with insight, based on the things that I've been through, based on the bad things that I've been through as well as the good things. And the bad things, I don't even look at as bad anymore, because I always found a way to make it a good, to make it a positive, to learn a lesson out of it, to not let it kill me and destroy me. And that's something that I want to share with a lot of you guys. Sometimes it is what it is. Life, let me tell you guys something. We're all pretty much, if you're on my channel, you kind of know what I'm about. I'm about progression. We talk about progression, success, etc. Now, with that, when you're in a progressive motion, when you're trying to succeed, good things are happening, you're making a positive movement forward, guess what? Negativity rears its ugly head. It's gonna happen, it always happens. That's the balance of life, that's polarity. You can't have, it's yin and yang, good and bad. You can't have good without bad. However, the bad has no power over us, right? So a lot of people, so you gotta be strong here and here in your spirit, in your gut. A lot of people get stuck in an emotional, when that bad or that negativity pops up, it hurts your feelings, it makes you sad, you know, or angry. And a lot of people never succeed because when they're faced with that negativity, when they're faced with that adversity, they get stuck in that emotional state. And guess what? Emotion. It's two words, E and motion. E means to emit, to omit, to stop. So you're stopping motion when you're dealing and existing in an emotional state. You cannot let that shit stop you. You move through it. The strong people, the people that make it to the top, the people that get that success, they never let that negativity stop. They never stop in that emotional state. To achieve greatness, you gotta go through great shit along the way. Great does not mean good or bad. So great tragedies, whatever, you will deal with it. It's gonna happen. It's happened to me. It'll probably happen to me more. But guess what? Every time you push through that negativity, every time you push through that perceived impediment, you get stronger, you get better, you grow. So once you push past it, you're stronger and you've gone to the next level. Now, when you're in that next level and that negativity and you're doing all this good shit and that negativity pops up again, guess what? It's easier. You recognize it. You've been there before. And you know that there's more sunshine than rain. And if it rains, you know it's going to be sunshine the next day. You know that you'll get through that shit with no problem. You know that that's not the end of the world. So you get through it. You go to that next level. Every time it becomes easier, easier, and easier for you to move past that negativity to where it's just a joke to you now. You laugh at it. I laugh at shit. When shit happens, when negativity pops up in my life, I'm like, good. This is an opportunity for me to become better. This is an opportunity for me to become stronger. And those forces that present themselves, those negative forces, they always die out. They always go away. And they have to look at me, whether it's people or whatever, it's usually people. And I continue to progress and excel and move forward and upward, and they decline, you know what I mean? To where they're non-existent. And they're watching me the whole time. You know what I mean? That's gratifying. That's gratifying, straight up. Now, if I was to get stuck in that emotional state and allow them to have power over me, I would be fucking, they win. And I'm a winner. I'm not gonna lose to them, you know what I'm saying? Gary Vee talks about, he said that he likes to lose, right? When we talked together in Manhattan, he asked me, do I like to lose? I said, no. He said, I do. I understand what he was saying, and he and I, we're saying the same things in different ways. The reason he said he likes to lose is because he likes that lesson. He likes that life lesson, that experience. You know what I'm saying? And I get it. I say I don't like to lose. Just the way I word it is different, because if it's a loss, technically, to me, I don't take it as a loss because I've learned from it. I've gained from it. I've gotten stronger from it. I don't lay down and die to it. You know what I'm saying? I don't allow that to happen. So we're saying the same thing, just in different ways, you understand? But shout out to Gary Vee, man. That's a solid dude, that's my boy. But anyway, back to what I was trying to get across to you guys. Don't get stuck in an emotional state. Don't get stuck in, don't worry about the negativity. It's gonna happen, it's gonna happen. That's life. Don't fucking cry, don't break down, don't make excuses why you can't push forward. Push forward or don't, it's as simple as that. Deal with the negativity or don't. Anything worth having, you're gonna go through some shit to get it. That's a fact. Whether it's work, business, relationships, whatever it may be, you're gonna go through some shit to get it. Do things that feel right to you. Do things that feel right in your gut. If it don't feel right, don't do it. All money is not good money, okay? Just because someone is offering you money, and I'm talking to my people out here in fitness, people are offering you money or whatever to promote their product or this or that, you don't have to do it just because they're offering you money. Listen, people will respect you more when you're like, you know what? And you tell them why. I don't want to do this because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just break down your reasons. You know what I'm saying? When you just, you become like a, it's like a whore. You know what I mean? A label whore. All right, boom. I'm gonna post this today, tomorrow, this. If you're not really using the products, you don't feel it in your soul, do not fucking do it, okay? I'm trying to give you guys, show you guys the blueprint on being successful within the fitness industry, at least, without taking sponsorships. You don't need it, you know what I'm saying? Even for me, I stopped sponsoring people. There's people around me that I help out because I like them a lot, but I don't even do the sponsorship thing anymore because it's just not, and I am sponsored by two companies, and that's because one was Better Bodies, is because I absolutely love the company. I love Michael Johansson. He is a mentor of mine, and I learned a lot from him. And we're collaborating and doing my line with Better Bodies. So that's a great opportunity for me. And the other is Rider Wear Shoes. Their shoes are fucking dope. Y'all see them in the videos. They're comfortable as shit. I'm a comfort addict, and I like the product. You know what I'm saying? It's not about the money. It's not about any of that because I don't need the money, okay? It's about me liking a product. Okay, you wanna pay me for wearing it? That's how it is. I'm gonna put it out there. You get paid for sponsorships to promote people's products, but I will never, ever, ever fucking promote or push anything that I don't like, that I don't use, that I don't believe in. It's simple as that. I can't speak for 99% of the people out there, but as far as me, I don't give a fuck. I won't do it. You won't see Mike Rashid pushing something that Mike Rashid does not actually absolutely love, and that's a fact. Okay, so, and I don't want y'all to do it either because you diminish your self-worth when you're doing things like that. You can put on a smile and put on your fake posts on Instagram, but when you look in the mirror at night, you know that you're fucking up and a piece of your soul fucking dies. You know what I mean? So don't do that. You don't want that to happen. You know what I mean? So anyway, message of the day for Mike Monday's episode 11. Stick to your guns. Do not do things that don't feel right in your spirit, that don't feel right in your gut, okay? Don't sell out for money, okay? Don't sell out for anything, right? 2, when negativity arises, it will arise when you're on a progressive path, fucking kick it in his nuts. Mayweather always says, tough times don't last, tough people do. That is so fucking real. Tough times do not last. There is always sunshine after the rain. The shit, cloudy days do not last forever unless you live in Portland or Seattle. But anyway, got a lot more shit to do. I'll holler at y'all on the flip side. All right? Peace.